was heading over towards the box here. We'll figure this out in a minute as they...
I think it's Rope
hits.
Penalty
on the play. Dallas, number 24, has 2 minutes for slashing.
And he just knocks the stick out of Jamie. He then knocks the stick out of Hyman's and keeps going after him. And yeah.
And Jamie Benn, it should be noted, a skilled player, a former scoring champion in this league, but he'll take on anyone as well.
Anyone in the league today.
And his stick gets dragged onto the ice. But that'll be the part of the game that he's want to try and get in gear as quickly as possible, as soon as tomorrow, Stevie. And that's the timing on the one-timer as Gionta going at it with two over there. He got checked into the bench. Crazy part of the game sometimes. Now watch Gionta. Kulikov knocks him into the bench. As he gets up, Brendan, I'll help you, buddy. He throws him over the boards, and I don't blame Steven Gionta to go at Brennan, the New Jersey native.
Down into the corner, cut off there, tried to work it out front. Marchessault, a backhander, and a save by Talbot.
Again, Cam Talbot there to save the day. Some extracurricular activity around the front of the net. Of course, Nick Deloria is right in the middle of that. Again, as I mentioned, Jack Eichel's been by far the best player, most dangerous player here. Turnover right down below the goal line, and Jack, or Cam Talbot, does an outstanding job of just staying with that. Front of the net, pulling Carlson away from the score. Marchessault didn't think that was really cool, came over and gave him a shot.
Zadorov is tied up with Sanford and throws him to the ice and's not letting go. Was way behind the play. And Nikita Zadorov at 6'5", 235, just manhandles Zach Sanford down to the ice. Let's take a look at how this all started. Zadorov goes to the room. So this is earlier. This is earlier in this period. Pretty good hit at the blue line. And then this is just now. We'll sort it out when we come back. Flames down by three.
Atkinson's stick has been broken, and he's jawing with Marchand. He gets an escort to get a new stick.
See the reaction of John Tortorella. Don't get engaged. Why was it broken? No, there's why, because he stepped on it. No wonder he's saying at some point there, that's why he gave a slash on it. That should have been a penalty on Marchand right away.
And Marchand with a little hook on Atkinson.
In a little over 8.5 minutes to lead the Bruins 3-2 after 40 minutes. Yeah. Actually, they were just decision-making by Boston. You got a real good team that you're playing against. They showed it in period two. Boston's got to be content with the effort that they've had through 40.
Big-time stuff here. This is what happened at the end of the second period. Jari's trying to give that to a fan. Marchand takes it off his stick. And they have words. And then Marchand's just going to throw the puck away.
Crosby either broke his stick or he lost his stick. And he was in coverage on Marchand, trying to get to the bench to get a different stick. Yet he still wanted to defend, and Marchand wanted to tie him up and not let him get to where he wanted to go to get some new lumber. And it allowed Charlie McAvoy on the other side of the ice to step into the offensive zone. He just couldn't drag the puck with him enough.
Deflected in as Martin gives chase. He and Benning go hard in the backboards. Puck's handled by McGinn. A little too far for Martinuk. Martinuk loses his edges. Benning takes him down and keeps him there. Still on top of the Canes' alternate captain. The Canes are playing on. Pesci has it. And now Martinuk is ready to go. He's had enough. Benning swinging haymakers on Martinuk on the ice. And the linesmen have to step in on that. Oh, tempers are ablaze here at PNC Arena.
Well, you remember Martinuk's big fight in Tampa, as big of a win. It was in the second period. As big of a win as there was in the regular season.
Well, for the Hurricanes, 7 minutes, 57 seconds to go here in the second period. And a 1-0 lead. Jordan Martinuk and Matt Benning, they're not going to be exchanging Christmas cards, that's for sure. 7:57 to go in the second period. Jordan Martinuk and Matt Benning in the penalty box for this trip.
Is an altercation. It's a great battle. Great battle. Martinuk gets up. His gloves did stay on, but they will square off. Okay, so off they go. Now, is a fight over when a player is on the ice? You bet it is. When Ovechkin fought Svechnikov, once Svechnikov went down, was the fight over? As much as I didn't like parts of that. In the surge, Evander Holyfield and Jordan Martinuk. Once Jordan went down, now that's a player safety issue.
Oh, Connor Murphy.
Yeah, Max Domi's going to go for hooking there, and he knows it. He goes right back at Murphy for the look. Drops the gloves, cross checks Connor Murphy, and now he's jumped him. I would say Max Domi's going to be going to have some extended time down the runway here. As I'm not sure what he got so upset about. We'll take a look at this, but Max is going to go for hooking, and then he went back and cross-checked Connor Murphy, and then he dropped his gloves and gave Connor no. Yeah, he's going right to the locker room. Take a look at this, see how this happened. There's the hook on Murphy. Max is mad now. He comes back. Cross check. That breaks his stick. Drops his gloves. And Connor says, no, I'm not fighting you. Something else must have happened. As Max was very fired up.
Final minute of play in the second period. See, Corey Perry's lost his stick in the Calgary bench and punching away, trying to get it.
Shea Theodore in off the wing with a shot. He scores off the glove of Elliott in the final minute. Theodore with a shot off the left wing, and it's a two-goal game.
And here's Corey Perry has lost his stick in the bench, so he's going to try and reach in and get it. And guys are giving him a little shot. And linesman over him. There's more at your bench.
Oh, and a diving play to knock it away by Matt Calvert. Green hits Calvert. Green goes down.
Good hit there, though.
Plenty of hits in this
look
game.
Out, look out. We got Spear going on.
Oh, here. And right at the bench. Calvert, Spear, oh, and the Red Wings holding up. And Calvert in the middle of it over there.
I got better off. He's bigger than anybody, and look for me. Who's he got a choke hold on? Have you? I can't see who it is. Matt Gabby. One big drink of water. I'm gonna
guess he is.
And Advocate is not afraid of him at all. I mean, that is some serious business, I'm here to tell you.
We're reincarnated in the mid-90s. Clock above center ice.
Well, what happened is they grabbed the
ball. Oh, yeah.
That's what started it. And he tried to spear that, you know. That's what's
going on. So Rasmussen grabbed the stick. That's a no-no.
Yeah, but anything goes. And
as long as it's not caught. We're very interference that the ref saw it.
We're very it subtle, is. Very
yeah.
subtle.
Yeah.
We're very close to Hudson Bay rules here.
Get out. Now the easiest way is to get out by dropping your stick, but he doesn't. Subban loses his for a second and then grabs Crosby. And so the discussion, look, having a discussion with the ref there, you got about five shots there by Crosby that could easily be called. And then when Subban finally came up, I guess Meyer, we've seen a lot let go in this city and by or in this series rather by these two officials especially. Finally goes up when he can even it to 4-on-4.
Goes to a knee arrest after that wrestling match late in the shift. And with a minute 32, they're both going to get an early exit to the dressing room.
Just 2 minutes each to Crosby and Subban.
We're in the second, and that puck's going to slide back. That's Miss Darlene. Watson goes to the bench. Now a strip by Norris. He's got a man going to the net. That's Tkachuk hanging around there, and a penalty coming up here. tripping call as the Senators create some havoc, and now Rasmus Dahlin in front of the net. You've got Tkachuk, you've got Norris, Hamonic in there as well.
And don't worry, Skinner's coming in. He'll settle the whole thing down there.
89 is there, right behind 26.
Casey Mittelstadt is a guy, I think, getting the initial penalty that was over in the corner. You see Casey making his way to the box right now. He's putting pressure on Norris, and he goes down. He kind of falls there, and then he gets tied up with the feet of Norris and takes him down. I think he's going to get a tripping call here. And he has come in. He sprays Norris right in the face. And that's where Norris got up and went back at Dahlin.